So what are the Pandora Papers? The Pandora Papers, in fact, are the largest ever media collaboration that has ever been mounted with the help of the ICIJ. There are a record number of 600 plus journalists working on this project from 150 countries. And even some small territories have a representative on this investigation. So we come back to such a large offshore investigation after the Panama Papers, but this time the number of service providers are also the largest, and there are 14 of them. Like in the Panama Papers, you had documents from Mossack Fonseca. This time there are 14 service providers, and some of the largest of them are, for example, Alcohol, Asia City, and the Trident Trust.
Like our previous offshore investigations, the Pandora Papers also expose instances of potential wrongdoing, such as money laundering, round-tripping, parking of black money, and such. Why is it important? Because companies are entitled to corporate veil, under which creative bookkeeping can explore and exploit legal loopholes to dodge taxes. And basically, a company can arrange its finances in any which way it wishes to, within existing laws, to reduce its tax liability. And the regulator is not encouraged to go fishing for nullified transactions based on merely some suspicion of wrongdoing until there is evidence. And once a fraud is established, the regulator can break into that opaque corporate structure, because a fraud unravels everything, even a law, if that comes in the regulator's way, because no law is intended to protect fraud. Since Panama Papers, our investigations have unearthed a long list of such leads and evidence which has helped lift the veil of secrecy. The Pandora Papers is another step in that direction.
In Pandora, the documents reveal how the rich Indians and those in the corporate world set up trusts and private investment companies outside India and into tax havens such as BVI and Cayman Islands. A new trend that we see in Pandora Papers is that these influential families or corporates, they have got one of their family member who's either become a foreign national or an NRI, and he's operating from there. He's doing his business from there, maybe Middle East or some other country. As these NRIs have set up the companies, in most cases they have mostly delinked the Indian business with a foreign this tax haven company that they have set up. So this is an additional layer that of care that they have taken this time, which the documents reveal this time. They are taking to avoid compliance and domestic regulation.
In terms of the size of the data set, also this is one of the largest ever. It is 11.9 million documents or records that we have spent 8-9 months examining, and so have the 600 other journalists who are working on the project. And in terms of the variety of subjects that we got, that is also very interesting.
So when the data came for our search, there were more than 61,000 names which were documents which were related to India. We first scrutinized those names. Then there were several documents where there was no India reference. So ICIJ has developed this time a very efficient system of search that is called data share. And on the data share, there is one batch search through which you can upload an Excel file comprising names which you want to search, and that results all the documents available with those names. So we used that system extensively, and I can tell you that since the companies and trusts are mostly incorporated since 1971, so I prepared an Excel sheet of all the MPs elected since 1952, all the union ministers, all governors, all chief ministers, all several states MLAs, and all the corporate leaders.
Besides the corporates and the industrialists, we have celebrities, which include people from the world of film, the arts, and sports stars.
Many persons and entities that have been named in the Pandora Papers are no strangers to investigative agencies in India. In fact, A number of these people are already under the scanner of the Enforcement Directorate, the Income Tax, the Central Bureau of Investigation, and the Serious Fraud Investigation Office. In almost all of these cases, the Pandora Papers reveal new data and documents pertaining to the cross-border dealings of these persons and the companies that they own.
I have prepared a list of all the FCRA registered NGOs. So when we uploaded these lists, CSV files on those badge searches, very good results came out, and that was there finally. You can see that we have names of politicians, we have bureaucrats, we have industrialists, we have actors, celebrities and sports persons. So that is how all this search we have done. Then we have done several related searches from registrar of companies, other countries related ROCs, then land registries and profile searches on social media website, social media profiles of the individuals and companies. So that is how finally we prepared that subject that on whom we should do the stories.
In Pandora Papers, we are essentially looking at how trust makes so much of sense to Indian business persons, and why have they caught the fancy of Indian business persons, the rich and the famous, and those who have kind of found themselves on the wrong side of the law for long. There are three or four very interesting reasons why Indian business persons are setting up trusts. One, essentially, it offers them an enhanced, secrecy. So lifting the corporate veil, as they say, it becomes much more difficult because of the complex nature of the trust structures. Trusts essentially, have four elements. One is, of course, the settlor who sets up the trust, the protector who derives power from the settlor to kind of supervise the trustee. The trustee is a person who manages the trust. And finally, there are a set of beneficiaries who derive the benefits which the trust distributes. Another element of the trust is that it insulates Indian businessmen. It helps Indian businessmen insulate their personal wealth from the liabilities that they take on the business side. What we have seen in the last couple of years is also many and many Indians are turning NRIs. Basically, an NRI is allowed to take much more out of India, much more wealth out of India legally. Like, he can take about $1 million a year. Essentially, trusts are all mechanisms for estate planning, but they can also be used for purposes such as, avoiding tax or concealing wealth or masking your own ownership of the assets which are vested in the trust.
In one of the stories that you'll be reading about in the next few days, we have detailed how a well-known promoter who is on the run from Indian agencies has continued to do business in India by opening a string of offshore units. In another case, we have found that a relative of an economic offender opened a trust to hold income from a company that has been accused of siphoning money loaned to it by Indian banks.
For anyone following our investigations into offshore finance in Panama Papers, this is more of the same exciting stuff. But this time, the range and the volume of the leak gets even bigger.